The day after the Highland Games, our group woke to say goodbye to our first driver, Brian, and hello to our second driver, Kyle. We had a great time on the Isle of Skye, but it was now time to see more of what this beautiful land had to offer. We started heading northeast towards the most famous loch in the country, one that has been home to a legend for thousands of years. I'm really excited because this is a bucket list item for me. We are on the shores of Loch Ness, looking for Nessie and a geocache, of course. So let's go find it with the group.
You're wondering, the bench is over there.
Where was the cache?
It's under the corner of the rocks here.
Pass me right up.
I didn't see him.
There's a boat out there. No sign of the world famous monster yet. If anyone's gonna find Nessie, I think it's geocaches. You can find anything, right? Find it?
No.
It's a micro.
Is it virtual cache here?
No, there's a traditional cache here.
Okay. I have no signal, so.
It's a 2 1.5 micro. Here.
Hey, it's.
Guys, I found her! I found Nessie! She's right here! She's on the wrong side!
Ah!
Loch's over there!
Thank you.
After seeing the famous loch, we made our way to Inverness for the evening. I found a few caches on my own before teaming up with K-Mans and Bindery Guy. It was here in Inverness that we saw some of the most creative caches of the whole trip. Unfortunately, I lost the audio for many of these finds, which is the only reason I'm putting music here instead.
Okay, this cache is awesome. So this must be the Scotland equivalent of a Walmart cache.
Thank you.
That is going to do it for today, you guys. We're getting closer and closer to Aberdeen and the UK mega event at this point. Tune in next time for some rich Scottish history and a really quick cameo from a geocaching vlogger you might know. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.